Good morning, students. In today's class, we will be discussing about the production of amino acids in the syllabus as it covers like glycine and glutamic acid. So basically, these amino acids are biologically important organic compounds containing amine, that is NH2, and carboxylic acid, that is COOH, functional groups, usually along with a side chain specific to each amino acid. So the key elements of an amino acid include like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen, though other elements are found in the side chains of certain amino acids. So in the form of proteins, amino acids comprise the second largest component. That's water is the largest of human muscles, cells, and other tissues. Outside proteins, amino acids perform critical roles in processes such as neurotransmitter, transport, and biosynthesis. So in this class, we will be discussing about the lysine production and glutamic acid production. So basically, these fermentative production of amino acids has become industrial reality by the discovery of efficient strains. It can be glutamic acid producer like Corynebacterium glutamicum, okay, which is synonym for Micrococcus glutamicus, and this was researched and published also by Kinoshita et al. In the year 1957. And of course, this bacterium was found during the time of increasing demand for monosodium glutamate, which is a flavoring agent. And following this, the research activity has been focused on microbial amino acid production to improve the nutritional value of low-cost vegetable proteins by enrichment with essential amino acids. So let's come to the topic of industrial production of amino acid, that is lysine. So lysine, it is abbreviated as LYS or K, capital K, encoded by the codons AAA and AAG. Okay, AA and AAG. It's an amino acid that is used in the biosynthesis of proteins. It contains an alpha amino acid, okay, an alpha carboxylic acid group, and a side chain lysine, okay, classifying it as charged aliphatic amino acid, and it is essential in humans. That means that the body cannot synthesize it and it has to be obtained from the diet. So it's an essential amino acid, as we just now discussed, for the nutrition of humans as well as animals, of course. And it is 2,6-diaminohexanoic acid, and usually used in supplementing cereal proteins lacking amino acids, and medically as a nutrient. Of course, Kinoshita was the first to report the fermentative production of lysine using homoserine auxotrope of Corynebacterium glutamicum. So here are the important features of lysine fermentation. As in the previous class, we discussed about production of organic acids. There, we started with the fermentation basic information. So let me not go, deeper into the fermentation aspect as such. As I told you, it will be more or less common, the fermentars used or the type of fermentation that's happening. Let's concentrate here more on the sources, rather the media composition and the cultural conditions which are necessary, because each and every organism, the conditions might differ, the cultural conditions, especially pH, temperature. So we should be having little bit idea as to what exactly is the pH requirement and temperature requirement of that particular organism for production of a particular product. Okay, so then the operation mode, like which type of bioreactor that is being used, whether it is batch fed or all of those things, and the downstreaming processes. So when it comes to the media composition, of course, the main important sources being carbon. So as carbon source, you can use, we can use glucose, fructose, sucrose, soluble starch, and the nitrogen sources being ammonium, nitrate salts, yeast extract, soybean protein, I mean the hydrolysate of these proteins, soybean protein also could be used. And in this case, the cultural conditions, especially for the production of lysine, the organism usually prefers, pH of around 7, that is neutralized. Usually, it will be neutralized by ammonia or urea addition. And the temperature of around 28 to 30 degrees centigrade. It requires high oxygen concentration. So that is most important here. Operation mode, of course, still tank bioreactors are best. Batch, fed batch, design goes with the performance of the organism. And, still tank bioreactors would be the best option here. And the downstreaming process here again, how important the upstreaming process until the fermentation, even the downstreaming process is also very, very important. If we think that, the raw materials used, or rather the cheaper source of raw materials, if it is used, maybe the cost of downstreaming process could be more. So if we have to design a particular process, we need to think of both upstreaming process steps and downstreaming process step, because we are thinking on a commercial scale. So in the downstreaming process, as usual, it will be cell separation, maybe by centrifugation or ultrafiltration, then concentration, that is cation exchange resins and elution with alkali, neutralization using hydrochloric acid, and finally crystallization by spray drying. So this lysine biosynthesis can be done by two biosynthetic pathways. One is DAP pathway, that is diaminopimelic acid. It's an intermediate which is found in bacteria, algae, and higher plants and umbilicuta. Wherein pyruvate plus aspartate gives diaminopimelic acid, which will then be converted to lysine. This is one of the pathways which usually occurs in bacteria, and we use mostly the bacterial culture. So that is where DAP pathway would be the best suited one. And in case of AAA, that is alpha amino adipate pathway, this is an intermediate which is found in fungi and eugenoids. Here acetate plus alpha ketoglutarate gives alpha amino adipate, and which will then be converted to lysine. So animals don't synthesize lysine. That's how we, in fact, initially discussed that it is a essential amino acid. You need to provide it by the external source or through diet. And as just now we, in the previous slide, we discussed about the important features or parameters. Here, the chief ingredients for the medium would be glucose. That's this carbon source, 2.5% glucose, 0.5% ammonium chloride, and mineral salts. They are very, very important. It can be also in some cases you can use for the seed culture peptone beef extract, and along with mineral salts. And the strain grew and accumulated L-lysine in purely synthetic medium. So that's the synthetic medium. And among the different hydrocarbons and nitrogen sources tested, gas oil at 4% and ammonium sulfate at 0.4% were found to be best compared to any other combinations or different sources. So different vitamins and antibiotics stimulated the growth and lysine yield. That's again very, very important. Here, the main starting material culture medium is L-aspartic acid, of course, 1 to 10% by weight. It's important for better yields of lysine. So inoculum of 7% of the medium was found to be optimal. The yield of lysine under optimal conditions was 3.4 grams per liter of medium. So this is the schematic diagrammatic representation or biosynthesis of L-lysine, wherein glucose is converted to lysine, that is glucose to aspartic acid, and in presence of aspartate kinase, it is converted to aspartyl phosphate. Aspartyl phosphate to aspartate semialdehyde. Semialdehyde is converted to dihydropicolinic acid, and then to diaminopimelic acid, and finally to lysine. So this is the biosynthetic pathway of lysine in Corynebacterium glutamicum. So Corynebacterium glutamicum is the best organism for biosynthesis of lysine. And the pathway the representation goes like this: aspartic acid to aspartate semialdehyde, to homoserine and to threonine. And here in this case, aspartate semialdehyde to L-lysine. By Friedbach inhibition, again it can synthesize aspartic acid. So, but otherwise, aspartate semialdehyde to lysine. Of course, homoserine can eat L-methionine. So, Sen in the year 1983 isolated Micrococcus variants from Assam soil and was able to accumulate around 2.6 grams. So, when compared to 3.4 grams of in the other organisms. This was purely synthetic medium under optimal conditions. So supplementation of the synthetic medium with amino acids significantly improved the yields. So, but optimum pH, carbon and nitrogen sources, as we previously discussed in the previous slide, hydrocarbon utilizing strain of Arthrobacter globiformis yielded 3.4 grams of lysine in the medium. But on the commercial scale, mostly preferred organism would be Corynebacterium glutamicum. So also here, excess of leucine inhibited synthesis of lysine. So therefore, leucine oxytrope was used. So excess biotin, whereas in this case, excess biotin favored the lysine accumulation. Addition of antibiotic and micronutrients to the optimal medium stimulated the cell growth and of course enhancing the yield of lysine. So coming to the applications of lysine, it helps to manage the sores caused by herpes virus, and it also helps in formation of bones and muscles. It also improving athletic performances, boosting immune system, and of course promoting insulin secretion. So this is very important amino acid commercially. So also its production commercially also it is very important. So it along with all the, it also improves the feed quality by improving the absorption of other amino acids. This is most important for any of the amino acids. Absorption of other amino acids is also being done by lysine, and also protein quality of certain foods is improved, resulting in improved growth and tissue synthesis. And generally it is used as feed, animal feed industry. It's used in animal feed industry as feedstuff additive. So it is mixed with several livestock cereals which do not have enough lysine, L-lysine. So basically it is one of the important amino acid covering more than 90% of the total amino acid production. So as such, to summarize, the Corynebacterium glutamicum is highly used or preferred in industrial productions along with the Brevibacterium flammum. So that is also one of the important organism that could be used. The fermentation technology, as discussed, it could be by batch fermentation, feedback, or continuous, like in the form of chemostat. And of course, downstreaming process would be separation, purification, crystallization, and drying. So with this applications, the production and the commercial production, or rather the industrial production and its applications is done. Now let's move on to the other amino acid. It is glutamic acid. So this glutamic acid is also one of the important amino acids. So this glutamic acid is abbreviated as GLU or capital E, encoded by the codons GAA or GAG. It is an alpha amino acid that is used in the biosynthesis of proteins. It contains an alpha amino group, an alpha carboxylic acid group, and a side chain carboxylic acid, classifying it as a polar negatively charged aliphatic amino acid. It is non-essential in humans. The previous one that we discussed was an essential one. That means, essential means it has to be provided through diet. But here in this case, it's a non-essential, meaning the body can synthesize it. So in neuroscience, its carboxylate anion glutamate is an important excitatory neurotransmitter, which plays a principal role in neural activation. So it is derivative of glutamic acid is derivative of glutamic acid, and the most importantly, monosodium glutamate, which is used in the development of flavor in the food products. And this is produced by many ways. That's by hydrolysis of wheat gluten, soybean cake, or other proteinaceous materials, or by cleavage of pyrrolidone carboxylic acid in molasses. And it can be done by one stage fermentation process involving single microorganism, or it can also be done by fermentation process where alpha ketoglutaric acid is produced by one microbe, and this in turn is converted to one glutamic acid by another microbe. So Corynebacterium glutamic is mainly used for one stage fermentation process. So this monosodium glutamate is freely soluble in water, but it is not hygroscopic and is insoluble in common organic solvents such as ether. And it is generally stable under food processing conditions. It's been used for more than 100 years to season the foods. They say that, it dates back to 5,000 years when cheese was known. Since then, this its existence is there, but on commercial basis, it's been used more since more than 10 years. So, glutamic acid was discovered and identified in year 1866 by German chemist Karl Heinrich Ritzhansen, who treated wheat gluten with sulfuric acid. And Dr. S. Ukada and Dr. Kinoshita in 1957 were successful in commercialization of this monosodium glutamate. So here also the important features of this glutamic acid fermentation include the medium composition as such carbon sources, glucose, fructose, sucrose, of course molasses, and crop hydrolysates can also be used, and nitrogen source in the form of urea, the best preferred sources. That's what there might be many other different nitrogenous sources, but the best preferred would be source in the form of urea. And excretion inoculation here, the biotin limited medium is used because excess of biotin also hinders the production. So it should be provided in suboptimal conditions. So that is important. And addition of detergent, antibiotics, and also temperature upshocks also to be maintained. So cultural conditions include pH of 7 to 8, which is controlled, using during production of acid, and temperature of 30 to 34 degrees centigrade. Here also oxygen is required. Operation mode can be still tank bioreactor batch fermentation process or fed batch. And downstreaming process in this case also includes cell separation, concentration, crystallization by decreasing the pH. So schematic representation of how the process takes place. Here the pure culture is inoculated into the seed culture, using the seed culture, and then all those parameters which are there for fermentation are explained here. Seed tank, a pH controller unit, a fermentar, which is the main tank, and then culture medium, that is important, and preparation tank, same centrifugal separation, and for the downstreaming process, these are all the ones, the centrifugal separation, ion exchange columns, crystallizing tank, and crystal separators and dryers. So probably in industrial microbiology, you would have studied in detail as to what different types of fermentars and what are all the different processes, upstreaming and downstreaming processes that are involved. So those things you can apply it over here. It may not go into very much details of the construction part of it. Let's just mention what is the type of fermentation that's being used here. So this is the biosynthesis of schematic diagram of biosynthesis of glutamic acid, wherein glucose is converted to acetate and to acetyl coenzyme A, and then citrate to isocitrate to alpha ketoglutarate, and in presence of ammonia to glutamate. So in the pathway it also goes through like succinate, fumarate, malate, oxaloacetate, and then again that's what with the addition of ammonia can get glutamate. So in the application part of it, it's very, very important in metabolism. So used in treating neuropathic diseases. As we all know, it is a flavor enhancer that's in the form of monosodium glutamate. Most of the Chinese foods will have this agent. Without this, you cannot expect any of the, especially Chinese food. So as such, monosodium glutamate, it is high in gluten diet, okay? So which is high protein diet, it is dangerous because once they are metabolized, they produce ammonia, and this ammonia is toxic, causing mad cow's disease or bovine serum encephalopathy. So in a limited concentrations or proportions, it is fine, but it should not be in too excess, because high in gluten, it's usually found high in gluten diet. As such, we told, right, excess production of ammonia is toxic. So, but then this is used as a flavor enhancer and plant growth for, plant growth as in the name of OxyGrow at the rate of 30%, and various industrial applications as a thickener, bitterness relieving agent, and as a cryoprotectant. It's also, as we discussed initially, it is a neurotransmitter, and it also acts as a biological adhesive. PGA, that is polyglutamic acid, is a naturally occurring biodegradable anionic polymer. So it is safer to use, environmental friendly, without any pollution. And also it is a heavy metal absorber. So with all these functions, that's how the industrial or commercial production of glutamic acid is found very, very important. So with this, we are done with the production of amino acids, lysine and glutamic acid. This is important with respect to exam also, as you might get one amino acid and one organic acid or solvent or any other product. Okay, it's up to the paper setter to decide. So this is also one of the important. So the main points here to remember would be the organism and its cultural conditions, the nutrient parameters, the biosynthesis aspect, the yield parameter, and then its application. This much if you can represent, that would be more than sufficient. So have a great day. Thanks for your patience.